What's up, guys? Psycho Serpent here, and I just went over the little ghost traveling tutorial for horror maps, and now I'm on to somewhat of a trail pack. So real quick, trail pack for mods. So real quick, I'm just going to go into F30 and mark down my chords, which would be 24.526. And then 238, and then -145.637. So those are my chords, and I copied this little thing from the red zombie versus green zombie thing, which would be on Dragon Oz thing. I got that from him, and I just went into the paste bin, and I got this because I sort of keep on forgetting this code. So execute at E, that is all entities, and then, so all entities with the name RZ would have this effect. So real quick, I'm just going to create a mob over here, / summon zombie, let me just put those chords back in, and it didn't save, who cares, zombie, -24.526, 238, and then -145.647. So, So I'm just gonna get out of that and then re-go into it. And actually, I'm gonna make it a blaze instead for the mob, just cause I don't want the zombie dying or having to add a active effect, cause that's a bit harder. I just wanna get this done. And then, there we go. Custom name Inferno. So I think I did that right. Hold on. I'm not used to the custom name part. Let me just check one of my commands. Somewhat. Okay. This needs that. And then custom name visible one. And then okay, so let's make sure that works. Let's go here. As you see, he doesn't have a name. Okay. Hold on, I messed something up. What did I do wrong? Custom name visible at one. Does capitals really count? Really? Okay, let's try this. Custom name visible one. Yep, there we go. So now the name tag works. And now I'm just gonna go over here and do so right now it is the execute command, and I messed that up. So let's execute. It would be the at E, and then name Inferno, and then let's just get rid of this. That would be its exact block. One would be. Hopefully, this doesn't matter. Okay, you know, I'm just going to put one for now, and then set block at E. That would be that, and then that, and then that, and then it would be. Okay, so after that, it would be Minecraft. fire. Leave, so. Block placed. Why isn't that working? Okay, so yeah, so I did that wrong. It should be that and then that. So now, whenever this blaze. Oh my god, let me just turn that down. Style creatures down to 60, okay. Okay, so now when he moves around, he needs a trail of fire. So, if I were to get like a diamond and then diamond chest plate and the game was zero, I'd basically have him with stuff. Yeah, so basically, let's just go back over there, take that off, and that. So, real quick, just gonna grab some food and go back and game on zero. So basically, what this is doing, it's doing all entities with the name Inferno. It makes them set a block with Minecraft fire. So, if you set this up at spawn, or the spawn chunk, which would be not here, it would be 0-0, I believe it would be 0-0, then, basically the redstone thing will never go out, and then you can just leave it at that, and, basically any mobs you can just spawn around the world with the name Inferno, or in the Nether or something like that will have that name. It is pretty useful for adventure maps. If you're sort of like a starter maker and you want to have like something like that, it could also be good for. It could also be good for. What's the word? Those kinds of maps when you're doing something like. What's that? Like a paint war or whatever. Where you just run around and there's like a carpet that follows you. And you have to get all. You have to get the most of your color out on the field. It could also be useful for, like, a skeleton with a pumpkin mask, and then have it be called, like, an ice, skeleton or something, and then have it have, like, the snow particle following it. So, yeah. You could also have something like this, where, hold on, let me just get, like, a sample. Just do a zombie, I guess, and then have a... summon zombie. That's. Oh, oops. Summon zombie. Negative 24.526. 238. Negative 145.647. Okay, so it's the same thing, and then. Custom name. Let's just call this one Iceman. Or yeah, Iceman. Sure. Right now, just Icy. Yeah, Icy. Okay. And then put the quotations around it. And then custom name visible. One and just okay. Let's just kill this guy. I'm just gonna spawn him. Actually, I'm just gonna spawn him right here. Okay, so let's just move this guy over that way. Where is he going? There's a villager. Oh, okay. Which one is there? There's a villager. Let's just move him out there. And put a whole bunch of glowstone around him because we will need that. He doesn't want to be in the light, apparently, but too bad. Okay, So now I'm gonna go over here, back over here, do that same command name icy, and have it be so before it was slash set block, and then that was the one previously. So I'm gonna do now is negative one, and then what I do now is Minecraft ice. Will that work? Oop. Okay. Just. So you walk? Okay. No. Hold on. I messed it up. Sorry about that Skype call. Okay. Now it should work. I see. Work, please. And I'm getting spam Skyped. Why aren't you working? You're ignorant. Should be working. Okay, I don't know what's going on with it. Oh, maybe it's because... Wait. Failed to execute. Let me check this real quick. www.google. Minecraft lock IDs. Look for packed ice or one of them. Fire ice. Minecraft ice. I don't know why that did not work. Maybe it's because it was a capital. Okay. Okay, so now I know why. You walk. You don't work. What's wrong with you? Okay, that one was more of a fail. Hold on, let me do something else. Minecraft. Just do redstone torch, I guess. Yes, yeah, so, that one did work. So basically, I could create like a mob that makes redstone torch patterns everywhere and lights redstone up. I could also have one that drops TNT in its place, which means it really can't walk very far, along with this one to make it pretty deadly. But whenever you hit him, since he's in air, he tries to turn an air block into a redstone torch, which messes up, and you get free redstone torches from hitting him. Just to let you know, and, yeah. I'm just gonna delete that one just in case, because I have a feeling it could possibly ruin that little thing. I'm just gonna remove that one, too. But, that's about it for this episode, guys. You can do it with, carpets, pressure plates, rails, I do believe. Snow, flowers, lily pads if it's like a water animal. Actually, with squids you could do it with like sponges. I mean that would come, or no, pufferfish, that would be even better. Not sure what happened with that that one that I tried doing, but you could also get it with half slabs to make it have them keep building up. You could do something like with lava if it was a blaze or something. That would be a little messy. Pufferfish with like a water block so that it continuously leaves a trail of water. Bats. Yeah, it's basically the possibilities are endless with this. And that's about it for this episode, guys. And I'll see you guys next time.